Yo, this is a motherfucker who needs no introduction. You are watching Breaking Records Radio.
There was something else I wanted to say too in the regard of the what we were talking about before, but I can't remember it exactly. But there was actually you bringing up the Memphis Bleek thing was another thing I did want to ask you about, because I seen somebody post that this morning as well too. And I wasn't actually familiar with you and Bleek's track. So when I listened, I'm like, yo, this is fire. So I know you kind of just broke down a bit of the what the recording experience was like, but how did you link up with Bleek to do the record to begin with?
I think that was the benefit of being on a label, because I think at that time, I'm trying to remember what EMI Music was releasing, like their what they were the umbrella of. I know it was Virgin and Priority, and somehow, some way, because of that situation, because I just mentioned it, I said, man, they asked me about features and what would I like to do. And then I was like, yo, man, I'd love to work with Memphis Bleek. And somehow through those channels, they got the word out. And right now, Memphis Bleek has a Shocker Ice Cold Gold record sitting on his wall, shining.
That's amazing, right?
Yeah.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
That is amazing, man. You know, that's like, it's just so cool too when you think about it. You know what I mean? Like, for you to even like to be such a fan of Memphis Bleek at the time and to work with them. And then for you to actually give him a gold, like, you know what I mean? Like, he has
a trophy for the rest of his life. It boggles my mind sometimes, because, you know, you're always looking forward. So, but then sometimes when I actually look back and I'm like, yeah, that was pretty cool. I was actually thinking the other day, I was like, you know, the first time, I think it was for What It Takes. No, it was Let's Ride. It was Let's Ride. So that would have been my third Juno, actually. No, or second, whichever one it was. I'm talking like I got so many. Well, when I got one, I have the picture of my mom and my grandmother backstage holding like the envelope with the winner is and my name on it. And like, those are things that, you know, like you look back on stuff like that and it's like, yeah, I have that, you know, like I have that history. And, you know, sometimes you're always forward thinking. Sometimes it's good to look back and just be like, you know, like, and just look and actually appreciate for yourself the things that you have accomplished.
No, 100%. And you know, and I feel that completely, like, you know, because I'm and I think, I guess maybe every artist feels like this, and like, you know, even, you know, media personality, whatever, but it's like, I never, like, when I look back sometimes I'm like, whoa, I've interviewed people that like I never dreamt I would even have conversations with or be in the same room as or whatever. But it's like you're always constantly working on what's next and trying to accomplish a next goal. Or, and you know, and it's like everything that seemed wild 5 years ago just becomes a benchmark in your goal to your next, like to achieve your next goal, your next, you know what I mean?